It's called the Ati Rudra Maha Yagnam, a distinctly spiritual ceremony that's brand new to many spiritual aspirants in the West, but an ancient practice in the East. It spanned a full 11 days in May 2014, here in rural Forsyth, Georgia, USA. And it attracted spiritual-minded people from around the world.
What brought you here?
Yeah, that Yagna.
And why is that?
Because I heard that even you don't understand the prayer that affect you, that you get the benefit from the big prayer when you're part of it. Main goal was to enjoy being part of the Yagna. I am so happy.
The purpose of this yagnam, initiated by holy woman Amma Sri Karunamayi of India, world peace. In every religion, God is revered as light, as fire. This yagna is a supreme sacred fire ceremony for world peace.
I'm Johanna.
Johanna?
I came here from Colombia.
And you came here for what reason?
I came here because Amma gave me a dream and she came in a lingam and said, come. And then I found out about Ati Rudra.
Which affiliate?
And I was so blessed to be able to come. And then miracles happened and here I am.
People from all over the world. I've been able to talk to people from Croatia. I mean, many parts of the world. And it's been really nice to get to meet them.
Me gusta mucho como...
I like how.
I like how Swami teach us about to chanting Vedas.
Yes.
And to do yagnas. And this is a great occasion because we were performed here, the Mahayagna. I'm learning to reciting Vedas.
The Vedas being chanted throughout the duration of this 11-day-long ceremony are the oldest non-sectarian, non-religious scriptures of humankind. Combined with the fire, the Vedas, and the chanting, all of this is intended to attract the highest positive energy as a balm for a hurting world.
So we are here, 25 people from Croatia. There are three ladies from Hungary. This is Zagreb, Croatia. Then we have two persons from Serbia. Then we have one from Bosnia, one from Slovenia. So altogether, six countries are represented by a European group.
2 months ago, a friend of mine from the Sababa Center told me about a yagnam happening in Forsyth, Georgia. And I listened to her and I said, yes. At that time, I was not committed. I wasn't sure if I would be able to come. And so I said, yes, I'll think about it. And so about a month ago, I happened to go into Ted Henry's Souljourns. And I opened it up and it was the yagnam. So I click on it and I listen. And this young man, Michael, I believe his name,
yep.
And he explained the significance of the yagnam. And I've heard Baba discourse and I've listened to the explanation and I really loved it at the time. And then when I listened to Michael again, explain it in his own simple way, not simple, it's very profound, something inside me, well, what are you waiting for? So here I am.
Amma Karunamayi will bless the entire universe with Ati Rudra Maha Yagnam. Priest Dixit, you know, from India, will come along with the three other Indian priests. And, you know, I sensed it that it would be really colossal event and that really I have to be the next one to inspire, you know, first my group, Sound of Veda Fellowship, and then all our European brothers and sisters who are engaged in the Veda chanting, you know.
The yagna is one in 5,000 years happening.
I think it's a big event for the soul, for all those gathering here, and all the prayer is going in the earth and purify the earth and purify the nature. I think that big event is meant to be designed by God, and I think that is His will. We are all here.
This particular yagna is designed by Amma Karunamayi. Is said to be the very first in history to include women chanting the Vedas, the Rudra. And guiding the chanters, Brahma Shri Professor B.S. Nanjunda Dixit.
For the first time, I am conducting a program of this mega event, where I come across not only the men folk belong to different categories, but also equally important the women folk. I think that we have to appreciate the magnitude in which Amma took a decision to involve everyone, irrespective of caste, creed, color, religion, gender. Well, I sincerely thank Amma to that particular decision.
Embodiment of divine souls, Amma's most beloved sweet children. I love you like anything from the bottom of my heart, infinite times. What a great opportunity for all of us to witness in today the beautiful Ati Rudra in Georgia. We are all of us here. You got a great opportunity to be here today to in this wonderful so we have beautiful Dikshit Swami did so many Ati Rudra homas. So we request him to come and conduct this wonderful program. He came all the way, more than 70 years age now. In that age, he came across the oceans and comes to us and share his knowledge with all of us. Wonderful. We have a lot of Seva people here. They're going to speak every day because they read all the things. We have to listen what they're going to speak about God. We have to listen. So in our billions and billions and countless gazillions of lifetimes, punya, that's merits, make you to sit here today to witness this beautiful Ati Rudram.
Amma said that people would come here for the Ati Rudram from all over the world, and they did.
Is this your first time to America?
Yes, yes, it is first time.
And is this your first time with Amma?
Yes. I express she is avatar.
Is it very hard to learn to chant the Vedas? Is it very difficult?
Oh, it's very easy.
Very easy.
Yeah.
And you're here, is this your first time to see Amma?
Yes.
What can you tell me about Amma? What do you think about Amma?
I don't think about Amma, nothing but I feeling Amma and I feeling Amma Lam.
You feeling her love.
Her love, yes.
Is this your first time to see Amma?
Yes, yes, yes.
And how would you describe Amma? Who is Amma?
Love and peace. Yeah.
You would like to hug her?
Yes.
Amma and Swami, very small.
Yes.
Outside, but inside very big. Very big, very big. After Amma, I feel is my last incarnation.
Oh, how wonderful. Are you happy you're here in America?
I'm very happy, yes.
And you're from Zagreb?
Yes.
Why are you here?
For the Ati Rudram, only.
Really?
Not touristically. This is a very unique event, once in a history maybe. That should be respected.
Satyotpanna pancha mahapataka aditya jyotir jayate.
And the primary job for those who come here to chant? Practice, practice, practice.
It was, let's say, summer of 2003 when the Vedas were inaugurated as a regular program during Swami's Darshan. Mm-hmm. And I bought one, it was actually a double DVD, Anand, The Endless. So it was January 2004. And then slowly I start to listen and I start to learn.
You taught yourself?
Yes.
Oh my goodness, that sounds impossible, but you were able to do that.
With Swami's grace, I think, as we all of us have witnessed, everything is possible.
Everything is possible, including this 11-day-long Ati Rudra Maha Yagnam held in this part of the Georgian countryside. And this is how it all started.
Anna. Good.
Hundreds upon hundreds of volunteers from all over the eastern seaboard came together for a whole year to turn this dream of Amma Sri Karunamayi'S into reality.
I am Rakesh Patel.
Rakesh Patel?
Originally from UK. I'm a Baba devotee, Amma devotee. I love them like my mother and father. So we as a core team been working since August last year. And it's gone through a number of phases.
Well, it's like D-Day. Is it going to be ready?
Oh, it's going to be ready. Believe me.
Okay,
thank you. And you're going to love it.
Yes, this program is about to start. This is the sort of the initiation part of the ceremony. And then the actual Ati Rudram begins tomorrow morning.
A full 11 days of events were held here without charge for admission, and tens of thousands of meals were served here for free.
I hear the New Jersey cooks are going to be busy.
Thank you.
And turn off the small one.
Yeah.
We're making
pasta.
Kesari, shira. Okay. Shira, which is semolina, cream of wheat. It's sweet.
Okay.
It's got cashews, raisins, cardamom.
How do you go to a drawing board to prepare for such tremendous number of meals for people?
It's like cooking a home-cooked meal for 25,000 people. How do you do it?
You know, I don't know. How do you do it?
You just take it one and multiply it 25,000 times.
And what begins this 11-day chanting festival for peace? Starting the fire. Seven fire pits were constructed here, with more added later. And altogether, the Maha Rudra was repeated by over 100 people chanting the Rudram for a total of 14,641 times during this 11-day period.
This is amazing, amazing, unbelievable. This is the first time in outside India, you know? Where can you get or find blessing like this? It's just hard to believe. When we first started, we didn't know it was going to happen like this. But this is unbelievable.
Congratulations on your efforts as well.
Well, Isamma and Swami, we are nothing.
Before all the religions of the world, there were the Vedas, the oldest book of knowledge known to civilization. What they teach is oneness, and their message of world harmony? It is just as relevant today as it was tens of thousands of years ago. It is Amma Sri Karunamayi who dedicated this chanting festival to world peace and to empowering women and ending poverty.
Amma is fantastic. Amma is the divine mother, the forms of all the mothers. And today's Mother's Day, and we are celebrating with Amma Mother's Day on top of the last day of Ati Rudra, 11th day of Puja to Shiv.
Are you having a good time?
I'm having the best time of my life.
I am Maria Lala, so from Colombia, from Bogota. I met Amma for my first time in 1996.
And she's coming right behind you right now, which is a beautiful thing.
Oh my
God. So tell me what it was that attracted you to Amma.
Amma is my divine mother. She's Mary. She's my Mary.
She told me in an interview that she is Mary.
She's Mary. And I love too much Mary, the divine mother. So she's my mother. She's my guru. She's everything in my life.
I'm told she's an avatar, and after listening to her and being in her presence, she's definitely avatar, as Baba said. We all are divine, and so Amma is just a very divine being, so she's like a divine mother.
Are you having a good time?
Oh, of course, yes. You know, listen the Vedas chanting and listening Amma's messages is great for us to charge our spiritual energy.
Very good. You did a beautiful, beautiful job.
And when the chanting was done, the singing began. As always, for world peace.
Okay, right now we are going to sing a small song, easy song, Shanti Om. Let everybody pray for all the countries, continents. Let human race must be always in eternal peace only. Nobody must not suffer with any problems, women problems, children problems, Mother Earth, natural disasters, water problem. We are expecting water for all. We are expecting food for all, education for all, medication for all, peace for all. Okay, right now, let all of us, we have to stand and wave the flags, national flags.
Shanti Om, Shanti, Shanti, Shanti Om, Shanti Om.
And as the Ati Rudra Maha Yagnam begins to wind down, Amma has yet another blessing for those who traveled to this rural spiritual event. The Yagnam ended on the day of the American celebration of Mother's Day, a tribute to everyone's mother and divine mother. Many first-timers at an event of this duration, 11 days, wondered how they would do, from where might they find the energy for so long an event. But at its conclusion, this spiritual festival was a glowing success for everyone. Soon, it was time for Amma to be carried into the large hall, where many awaited her. Smoke from all the spiritual fires joined the chorus of greeting as many sensed the event was about to end. These people spent more than a week chanting the name of Shiva, known as the destroyer of evil, a chant that also helps to melt away the ego. These Vedas are universal in nature. They are for the good of all of humankind, and it is for the whole of humanity to benefit from this great treasure trove of boundless energy. After being here for most of 2 weeks, many participants were reluctant to have the yagnam come to an end. Amma Sri Karunamayi's world tour has brought her to the United States for 20 years. She promises to return next year as she continues her efforts to bring tranquility on earth for women's rights and to eradicate poverty. This Ati Rudra Maha Yagnam, and to learn more about Amma Sri Karunamayi and when she might be visiting your country or your city, visit her website, karunamayi.org.